Hi, this is Artillery SideWinder X-2 FDM 3D printer. The first thing I can say about this printer is that it's truly the quietest printer I have ever used. And in my eyes, it's a reliable, solid, and professional machine. The printer has a large AC heated printing bed, direct drive extruder, dual Z axis, and many more professional features. In short, this printer is almost perfect. We'll look at all of these one by one, and before starting the review, this printer was provided to me by Heka.com. There are many types of 3D printers and different products on Heka, and the best part is that they give a 50 bucks discount for this printer. That's really great, and quite a fair price for this printer. If you intend to get Artillery SideWinder X2, there will be a discounted code and a link in the description. You can get it cheap using the discount code, and I would definitely say take a look. Also, big thanks to Heka for sending this printer. SideWinder X2 offers a really large printing volume compared to most printers. I barely fit the printer on the table. I can't even use it that way because it hits the wall while working, and you can easily see the difference when I put it side by side with Ender 3. It can even be better understood in this way. Okay, we see a carbon doom glass bed as a printing surface, and as you know, the feature of these surfaces is that the print can easily stick to the surface when it warms up and can easily come off when it cools down. For example, right now the bed is 57 degrees and I can't take the print out, as you can see. It comes with the whole bed, but when the bed cooled down, I can easily take the print off. Also, since the bed is large, you may think that it will take a long time to warm up or maybe not good. But SideWinder X2 has a big advantage in this regard, which is that the printer has an AC heated bed, and when I did some research, I saw that the bed 500 watts, which is very high value. This AC heating method is one of the fastest options on the market for heating bed, and this large bed up to printing temperature in about 50 seconds, which is really cool. The high voltage heating and sensor wires of the bed are also nicely insulated here and move nicely in a channel. It goes from here into the printer and is directly connected to the power input with socketed in this way. When I look at the bottom of the bed, I was really surprised, because the printer doesn't have an aluminum bed. Instead, there is just a textured glass, as you can see, and the silicone heating element is glued from the bottom to this glass, and there is quite thick insulation foam just below it. I see both leveling springs and bed calibration probe in the printer, which looks like BL touch. For the leveling, I'll do first manual leveling, and for that, I press the leveling option in the interface and do roughly manual leveling from 5 points. Then I press more and start the auto bed leveling. The printer is leveling from 20 different points right now. So the leveling ended at the back right, and I think the printhead won't come to the home position. And finally I set the Z offset. So we complete the leveling. When I look right next to the leveling probe, I see direct drive extruder here, which is a Titan extruder. The stepper motor is out in sight, but it's probably a pancake stepper motor. Okay, here there is a slim pancake stepper motor and nicely fixed on a blue metal part. By the way, the leveling probe is here. It seems a tiny thing. Just in front of the motor is the Titan extruder, as I said. In this way, a nice direct drive concept is designed, which is a big plus of having direct drive, because direct drive minimizes the distance at where the filament bend or jam and allows us to use the flexible filament without any problems. Just below the Titan extruder, I see a long PTFE-lined volcano-style hot end that can provide high flow and 0.4 mm nozzle. I think this direct drive and volcano hot end concept is very good choice, because SideWinder X2 has a larger print volume than normal, and this concept allows us to use the printer at high feed rate and high speeds. Out of this, there is a layer and block cooling fans here, and these fans are extremely quiet. Speaking of the silence, it's time to talk about it, because I'm not exaggerating, this is the quietest printer I have ever used. I'm dead serious. Whether it's the fans here or the fan on the motherboard, extremely quiet and almost don't even notice the printer working. As you can see, when I turn on the printer, the sound level almost no changed and is around 40 dB. I think the reason for this silence is that, as you can see, no fan is running even though the printer is on. The fans run when the printer warms up, but the sound level is still quite low. It's really quiet printer, And I think one of the biggest reasons for dead silence is that the printer uses a fanless power supply. Let's go back to the printhead. As you can see, all these wires in the printhead gather in a PCB here, and from there they go to the motherboard through ribbon cable. Similarly, there is one more ribbon cable here. To be honest, I don't like ribbon cables very much, sometimes they can be a problem, but I think they won't be a problem on this printer, because as you can see here, there are locking clips and they look pretty solid. Looks nice and tidy. And they also sent the spares just in case. On the printhead, there's a blue colored plastic casing surrounding the pancake stepper motor, PCB and leveling probe. I think the printhead looks very good, not too large, which we see a large and rough printhead in most direct drive printers, but I like this design. The printhead moves on an unusually thick extrusion with conventional wheeled carriages. I gotta say that this extrusion gives the printer a pretty solid feel. The wheeled carriages here also have a very interesting design. They are made of a cast aluminum, which is pretty unusual and it looks big and heavy. But I don't think aluminum will be too heavy after all, and these are not a problem at all for this printer anyway. Because the printer uses deal motors in the Z-axis to overcome all these direct drive, large extrusion and carriages. Which would probably be a problem if there wasn't double Z-axis anyway. However, the printer has a double Z-axis capable of meeting all this. And the movement in the Z-axis is provided through these lead screws and brass nuts, as in most printers. And since the print height is 400 mm, it's even longer than usual in these lead screws. These shafts are connected to each other by belts at their ends, so that both stepper motors can work synchronously, which is great and something we don't see in every printer. Also, there's a different coupling here. I don't know how this will affect print quality, but it's said to be patented design and provides better quality. Alright, now let me talk about the unboxing. The SideWinder X2 comes very neat. All spare parts and tools are in this bag. And as you can see, the printer comes almost installed and obviously not much to do for the assembly. We first fixed the gantry to the base from the bottom, but here, there's a PCB in the socket of the ribbon cable and you should be careful when installing it on the base. Once put the gantry into the slots over there, everything falls into place properly though. After placing the spool holder on the top, and I fix it well with the screw here, then we plug in all the wires. By the way, since the printer has a leveling probe, there is no end stop on the Z-axis, but I think they still left a wire for the Z end stop here, just in case. Finally, I plug in the wire of the filament sensor, and the printer is ready. It makes a really loud sound when it turns on, and the leveling probe here goes up and down. If there was no light on the screen right now, I wouldn't understand whether the printer was working or not. Oh, it's really quiet. Anyway, as you can see, the screen is tilted on the front left side of the printer. However, SideWinder X2 uses a 32-bit Artillery Ruby version 1.2 motherboard. We see the silent stepper motor drivers on the board. And as I understand it, I think the two stepper motors on the Z-axis are driven by a single driver. Because the socket that says Z2 here is unused, all nicely glued, quite solid. Right next to the motherboard, we see a small 24-volt power supply, which is quite normal, because the printing bed is AC powered. And therefore, of course, there is no need for a large power supply either. There is no fan in the power supply, as I said before. It's a fanless small power supply. Only on the outer cover, there's a large fan here. The inside of the printer also looks quite tidy and solid. As you can see, the base is supported by extrusions here. And I must say that the wiring is also quite neat. Okay, let's get our first print with 3D Benchy. By the way, in this glass pad, most of the people usually use adhesives or something. But after you have done the leveling of the printer well, you don't need any adhesive for this glass pad. And as you can see, even the letters in the first layer stick pretty well. But of course, it needs to be as clean as possible on the surface. Let's look at the pros and cons of the printer. The things I can say as the pros: large printing volume, AC powered printing pad, automatic bed leveling and bed springs are important, extremely quiet, direct drive Titan clone extruder, dual Z axis, and finally, the touchscreen and filament sensor can be added to the list. Besides, one of the things that impressed me the most is that Artillery really cares the printer. Even the wrench they sent has a high quality that we don't see in most printers and has its own tool bag. Instead of a small memory card, we have a USB, and one of my favorite things is that they even used ball joint for filament sensor here as well. All these little details make me feel that the printer was of high quality. Besides this, let's look at the cons. Obviously, the first thing, no belt tensioners. Screen touch is not that good, the eccentric nut adjustment is a bit difficult, and the last thing is that the printer doesn't have an aluminum bed, so we probably cannot use a magnetic printing surface if we want. So, as a result, if I had to sum up the printer, a smooth, professional, and quiet machine. This was Artillery SideWinder X2, and you can get it now at hekka.com for 50 bucks off. There's a link in the description for that. You should definitely take a look. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.